Okay, records. So now we're going to see how to start blockchain as a beginner. So before seeing that, we are going to see Hyperledger. So if you see hyperledger.org, this is the official site. So this has been invented by the Linux Foundation project. So in this site, they have provided some tools where we can learn and use blockchain for the beginner. But before understanding, the Hyperledger is the one of the product from blockchain to develop blockchain. Here you have different families of Hyperledger. You can see Hyperledger Avalon is a new one, Visio, Bureau, Catalyst, and you can see lot many Sawtooth, lot many Tello, lot many features of Hyperledger. But Hyperledger is the head or main part, and it has been have a lot of Hyperledger products. So Hyperledger Fabric is one of from IBM, and then Hyperledger Explorer, Hyperledger Grid, Hyperledger Andy, Hyperledger Ana, Hyperledger Cube. So there is lot of frameworks, Hyperledger Sawtooth, Hyperledger Transit. So you can see there's a lot of frameworks as available under the Hyperledger. This is the blockchain framework created by Linux Foundation. So before that, I just go to the Hyperledger wiki. So if you see here, we can able to see in Hyperledger there's umbrella of projects, because you can see there's a lot of projects under the Hyperledger and the related lot of tools available. Here there is some history, who found it. We already saw it's from Linux Foundation, and we can go in detail. Here I just came to talk about Hyperledger Fabric, and there is something called Hyperledger Composer. As a beginner, we can start using Hyperledger Composer and then Hyperledger Explorer. So the rest of the products will work as similarly, but we will see. So Hyperledger Composer is set of collaboration tools for building blockchain business networks that make it simple and fast for business owners. So it is actually very simple for new starters. And it's not a cryptocurrency, it is used for business related things, and developed to create a smart contract and blockchain application to solve the business problems. So it's built with JavaScript, leveraging modern tools including Node.js, NPM, CLI, and popular editors. Composer offers business centric abstraction as well as a sample application, which is easy to test DevOps process to create a robust blockchain solution and align business requirements with technical deployment. So basically, this is also a prototype from IBM. Composer is user-facing rapid prototyping tool. Okay. So what in this is right? If you are a beginner with the blockchain and you want to do industry-related use case, going with Hyperledger Composer as a start is a good solution. Then we can start with Hyperledger Fabric. This is the framework from IBM, and it was little stable. IBM are using it on cloud managed solution. And Hyperledger Explorer is another tool for checking the node and list like that. It can be run on top of Hyperledger Composer as well. Okay, so now we will see if you want to use Hyperledger Composer and design a project, how we are going to do it. So I have taken the architecture of Hyperledger Composer. Here you can see Hyperledger Composer enables architects and developers to quickly create a full stack blockchain solution. That is your business logic that runs on the blockchain, REST APIs that exposes the blockchain logic to web or mobile or web application, as well as integrating the blockchain with the existing enterprise system records. So it's almost it helps us, even your architect or your developer, it easily helps you to give the full stack development. That means from the infrastructure to the application, the complete full stack solution can be given, and you have to think about the business logic or your use case, what you are going to do. Okay, so now if you see this architecture, you can see there is something called Yeoman. Yeoman is a framework which generates the AngularJS application for you. Based on the, you can see Angular. So this AngularJS framework is for the UI interface of blockchain. And the blockchain, this Hyperledger Fabric exposes some REST APIs. So depends on the REST APIs, Yeoman will create a application. You can see Yeoman generates a skeleton Angular application using the starting point for your blockchain application. This will give, if you are a beginner with blockchain or if you are not good with development, then you can use this Yeoman framework. You can easily download this in any Linux using Gendata Hyperledger Composer. If you are using Ubuntu, you can use apt get install and this package. It's just a package. If you are using Red Hat or other things, you can use yum install and you can install this package into the Linux. Basically, this will give the skeleton Angular application for the use of your application. Then you can see there is a skeleton apps called REST API generated by the Composer REST API. So there is an REST APIs generated depends on your use case. You can see here Hyperledger Composer components, CLI, Composer CLI, Composer REST server, then Web Playground, and SDK. SDK is nothing but software development kit. So you can use ID cards. This ID cards is nothing but your smart contract, which you have been generated, and the runtime environment will be Hyperledger Fabric, Web, or Node.js. So we are using Hyperledger Fabric, but we are using this Composer tool as a starter kit to put our application. So if you see Hyperledger Composer, Composers of execution environment, JavaScript SDK, CLI, REST server, loopback connector is for our APIs, Playground web interface, and Yeoman code generator, VS Code and Atom editor, which something we can use it as an IDE for this AngularJS application. So now we will see how we can create this environment. Okay, right now this Hyperledger Composer has been designed to support as a pluggable runtime. Currently there is three runtime. Okay, one is Hyperledger Fabric version 1.1 to store the as a distributed ledger, and a web which executes the web page used to Playground. This is for local storage. Okay, we can use it as a distributed ledger, or we can use it as a local storage, or embedded and executes as a primary unit logic which stores in memory key store value, or it can be in memory key store value. Okay. So now we will see how we can what is REST server and what is loopback connector, what is Yeoman codeware. Everything has been given here highly, but now I will go to the installation part. So you have any questions on this architecture? Do you have any questions on this architecture part? I think you are in mute. Okay. Then I will just go with the installation. So here you can see to start with the installation, there is a start here button. Basically, they have hosted this in the IBM cloud environment where we can able to pull this, because this Hyperledger Composer is a tool for Hyperledger Fabric. Here you can see the prerequisites of your infrastructure. The first prerequisites will be your Ubuntu, either 14.04 or 16.04, 64-bit, or you can use Mac OS. Then you need this Docker engine to be installed, and Node.js, NPM, Git, Python, or a code editor, they recommend VS Code. And also the users should be root, do not SU to root, because it's an installation should be done under this. So when installing, you should unzip with sudo, and these things you can see better. Now all these installation prerequisites, it's been available into this script, prerequisites.ubuntu.sh. It's in the Git repository of hyperledger.io. You can just copy this, and then you can make your environment. If you have a Ubuntu, you can curl this from the Git, and you can use this. This we're going to see how to implement as well. Before that, we are just going to in the theory, but we will see how we will installing in the next session. So if you see here, once we're done with the prerequisites, there is two things. We have to install the development environment where we will develop this application. So you can choose in any installation method. Either you can choose a different updating, uninstalling. So if you see your development environment, it should have the CLI, NPM CLI. This is the client permission where you're going to access this thing. So we need a Composer CLI to access the Hyperledger Composer framework, the Composer REST server to create some APIs, and generator Hyperledger Composer is our to create the initial application code. Okay, then you also need something called the Yeoman framework as well, generator Hyperledger Composer Yeoman, which these things we need to install to make our after the installation, after prerequisites of the script, we need to have additional tools and CLIs to be installed to start with it. Here we have something called Hyperledger Playground, which is to create the smart contract. So we don't need to code our smart contract. We need to use the Hyperledger Playground. Either we can use it as a CLI or the playground available in the website as well. If you put Hyperledger Playground, you will get the online hosted tool from IBM to create this Hyperledger. So we will go through that in detail, but as of now the playground is to create the smart contract. Then there are some tools to build the Docker and remove the Docker engines. Then after the installation, so this installation, the first installation to set up the Ubuntu server, and second installation to install the tools and make the environment available for blockchain deployment. So once you are ready with this, all these tools, you will try to curl your Hyperledger fabric. Basically, you have to install Hyperledger fabric onto your Linux server. So you the first step, you just made your server ready with Docker, Node.js, npm, and these things. And the second step, you are installing some CLIs, and finally the framework, the blockchain framework, Hyperledger Fabric, you are installing. And it is also available in the Git Fabric dev servers. A lot of scripts is available. We can take one of the script, curl it, and we are going to run that. We're going to check whether what version of HL is Hyperledger F Fabric version 1.1. So this is the version, and once you give done download fabric.sh, it will actually download the complete Hyperledger fabric to our local fabric runtime environment. So once you've done that, we have to execute the start script. Okay, once you are expected, again you can check the same version you have imported, then you can start fabric sh script. This will actually start the fabric server. This will start the Hyperledger fabric in the Linux server, where this becomes a node, your blockchain node right now. Then create a peer admin card. This peer admin card is nothing but your smart contract script. So now we're going to deploy our smart contract, where we are going to use this Hyperledger Composer framework to create the smart contract. So as we install Hyperledger Playground tool into Linux, we can able to access that in our development environment using 8080, port 8080. Then we will create the smart contract. We will see how we will create the smart contract. Then we will host that contract as the peer card in the fabric. So this is how a beginner can easily create a blockchain solution. Developing the business network is nothing but how to create your smart contract. This we will see while we are doing this business network. So right now, any doubt on installation and running installation of Hyperledger Fabric node and Hyperledger Composer? Just you can unmute and okay. So then thanks. We will see.